So I'm going to the first question. Plant-based nutrition is still a concept unknown to many people. In my course, my postgraduate course, we discussed the environmental impact of sectors, including food production and food industry. When I first told my students that one can thrive on a plant-based diet, they dismissed my statement based on common knowledge. Reducing one's environmental impact through the adoption of a plant-based diet was seen as an absurd, non-feasible option. So, I would like you to address this. Is it really absurd not feasible? What would you like to say to our class about thriving on a plant-based diet?
Well, first off, a plant-based diet, I'd like to say, is a whole food plant-based diet. In other words, I'm not talking about the nutrients all by themselves, like a nutrient supplement. I'm not talking about that because they don't work very well. So I'm talking about whole foods first. Secondly, I'm also talking about the fact that now we have evidence, published evidence in peer-reviewed literature that we can actually cure heart disease, even advanced stages. We can cure diabetes, especially type 2 diabetes. And we have a lot of evidence now beginning to emerge to show that we can actually use this diet not only to prevent future diseases, but even more importantly, to treat existing diseases. And the way it works, it is not on the basis of one nutrient at a time. I mean, we don't choose foods specifically because of one nutrient or two nutrients. What we're doing, we're talking about plant-based foods, vegetables, grains, legumes, and so forth, and the whole food. And when we do it that way, that's nature. And nature has a very good way of figuring out how to use that food to actually treat our illnesses. And so it really works remarkably well. Cancer also, we have a lot of evidence too that it can be used for cancer too. That's my specialty. Although in the case of cancer, we don't have enough published research yet, but nonetheless, we can turn cancer on and off experimentally. So everything is really, really impressive that what we're now finding. And I think that this is something that you might enjoy to hear, being that you're in Greece. Hippocrates, you know, for many, many years ago, obviously was a famous physician. And so we have, in the United States, medical students graduate, and when they graduate, they take an oath, and it's called the Hippocratic Oath. So they honor Hippocrates by saying, okay, I'm a doctor now, you know, I took the oath of Hippocrates. And it's very interesting. Hippocrates, so he was honored by using his name, but he is not being honored by his ideas. Because Hippocrates said many years ago, let food be thy medicine, and medicine be thy food. He was famous for that. And so what Hippocrates apparently knew in those days, similar to what we're now discovering. So I'm simply saying that we are talking about using food as medicine for a variety of different illnesses. It's not one food affecting one illness or one nutrient affecting one thing. That's not what it is. It's about the whole food working together. And we can see results, incidentally. If you take a group of people, if we take a group of people, we select a group of people, maybe 20 or 30 or something like that, and we give them this food, in 10 days time, 15 days, 20 days, certainly. In that period of time, they will see effects that are quite remarkable. Blood cholesterol comes down. Blood triglycerides come down. If people have blood pressure problems, they tend to resolve themselves. And oh yes, I forgot to say one thing. This might be a little bit sensitive to your Greek audience. But when I talk about a whole food plant-based diet, I'm talking about not adding back a lot of oil. I know in Greece and Spain and Italy and so forth, you like to add, you know, a lot of oil. And I think in the old times, and from my perspective, you have to correct me on this. In the old times, I think olives, of course, are good food. Olives are good food. And if they were squeezed and you get the juice out of them, that's one thing. That's, I'm not talking about that. I'm talking about the excessive amounts of olive oil, for example, we use in the United States. We put olive oil on everything, or other kinds of oil. I mean, olive oil is better than, let's say, corn oil and so forth, but all oil. So when I say whole food, plant-based diet, I'm not talking about adding a lot of back to it. You know, we can talk about high fat foods like olive or avocado or so forth like that, or peanuts, groundnuts, maybe you say, but they're fine, but not the oil, not to take the oil out and then put it, you know, someplace in the food. Okay, that's probably enough.